holding back the worst impacts from climate change will require major changes to the world's energy supply, including in the transportation sector. Transportation accounts for about 28% of greenhouse gas emissions in the U.S. alone, and about 13% of emissions worldwide. Within that, light-duty vehicles, passenger cars, and trucks that meet certain size and weight measurements account for about 61% of all emissions. The U.S., in an attempt to tackle this issue, has set emissions reduction targets for 2030. How and whether climate goals are met will depend on both government policies and consumer decisions. But what does this all mean for the average car buyer? As a consumer, navigating through emission details and price points while researching vehicle options might seem overwhelming, confusing, or impossible. But what if there was a way to present this information that's easy to access and simple to understand? Well, a team of MIT researchers have done just that. In a recent study, the team evaluated the 125 most popular vehicles on the market against the emission reduction targets the U.S. will likely need to hit between 2030 and 2050, and they are releasing the results in the form of an online app called CarbonCounter. The way CarbonCounter works is pretty simple. You type in the vehicle you're interested in, and it appears as a data point on a graph of cost against greenhouse gas emissions. As one navigates through the app, data is presented and connections are made between various models of the same car, in comparison to others, to show consumers their options and compare them to climate goals. You can even look into the future, adjusting the costs and the carbon emissions of different fuels like gasoline and electricity, to see how far each vehicle technology can go in meeting the longer-term climate targets. By bringing all of this information together, right at people's fingertips, and showing how cars stack up against climate targets, the researchers hope this tool will help lower the barrier for car buyers to make cost and climate-saving decisions.